Hello and welcome to Information Security Governance, Risk and Compliance. My name is Salvador Vaz and today we will learn how to audit network security in 10 steps. Let's get started. Point number one, check and verify that there is a network security policy defined and reviewed regularly. In the policy, make sure that all the roles and responsibilities are clearly defined. Additionally, check and verify that the network architecture diagram is updated and regularly reviewed. Point number two, check and verify in the network diagram that the corporate network is segregated into different zones like DMZ, internal, production, etc. Also, check and verify that no external entity can directly connect to the internal network. Additionally, also verify that there is no direct connectivity between DMZ and the internal network. Point number three, make sure that there is no single point of failure in the network with respect to firewall, core switch, router, internet or telecom lines. Also, make sure that the guest network is segregated from the corporate network and there is no direct connectivity between the guest network and internal network. Point number four, make sure that there is a firewall on the perimeter of the network and security devices like IDS, IPS are implemented for threat detection. Point number five, make sure that the data in transit is secured by either an encryption or an SFTP or a VPN tunnel. Point number six, make sure that all the network assets are maintained in an asset register and any changes to the network devices go through a change procedure and make sure that the change logs are maintained and reviewed regularly. Point number seven, make sure that all the network devices are hardened and there is a baseline security policy defined and implemented. Additionally, make sure that all the network devices are installed with the latest security patches and the default user IDs and passwords are either changed or disabled. Also, make sure that the privileged users on the network devices are reviewed for their access. Point number eight, make sure that all the security related events from the network devices are logged to a Syslog server or an SIEM server and monitored for anomalies. Also check if the network devices are physically secure in the data center and access to the data center is controlled. Point number nine, make sure that the network resiliency is tested for the business continuity management and the network capacity is planned and monitored regularly. And finally, and most importantly, point number 10, make sure configuration reviews and rule-based reviews is performed on a regular basis. Vulnerability assessment and penetration testing of the network is performed regularly and all the issues are closed as per the policy. Do provide your feedback, suggestions and share the video. Thank you for watching.